Welcome to a lesson in determining change. In this lesson, we're going to learn about the notation to determine the changes in quantities and the changes in values. Let's begin. So let's look at this first example. Juan started on a new diet, and over the last few months, his weight has went from 196.8 pounds to 187.3 pounds. First part asks, what is the change in Juan's weight? Write the calculation that determines that change. So let's take a look at what's going on. First of all, let's think about the quantity in units. And the quantity we're measuring is weight, and the units that it's measured in is pounds. And what we're looking at really is the change in Juan's weight. So let's think about how that might be. So if we're thinking about change could be either positive or it could be negative. When we think about a positive change, we think of a gain. Now when we think of that visually, you can imagine that we have this number line, and let's imagine that, for example, you're starting at 190 pounds and you're gaining weight. Well, that would imply that from 190, you are moving to the right in this horizontal number line. So that would indicate a gain. Another way to think about this is a change in weight as a loss. So imagine that we're starting at 195 pounds and we're losing weight. So the number line, that would be indicated by an arrow going to the left. Again, we are using the horizontal number line, so the gains would be represented by going right from some starting point, and a negative change would be represented by going left from some starting point. So let's look at the question at hand. When we're looking at it, Juan's weight started at 196.8 pounds, and he finished at 187.3 pounds. That's what we're looking at in part A. So that's where the green dots is start, and you'll see the red dot ending corresponding to the starting and ending weights. There are a couple other ways to describe the starting and ending points that you will see in mathematics. For example, they might call it the initial point and the final point, and it's corresponding to the start and end. It's just another way to say it. Another way to say it is some point of reference. That point of reference is always referring to the point that you're starting from or the point that you're measuring from, and then there's some change from that reference point indicated by the red dot, which is where we'd be finishing. It might represent the most current value or might represent exactly where we stopped. And just to shorten it, I'm going to use REF or REF as a shortening of reference. So what we're looking at is from this reference point or the starting point of 196.8 pounds, there's a change of weight to 187.3 pounds, and that is a decrease, that is a negative. So the change is going to be negative when we're thinking about it. So let's look at the calculations. One might say, well, we could calculate this by taking 196.8 minus 187.3, and that gives you 9.5. Or you might say, to figure out the change in weight, you would take 187.3 minus 196.8, and then you get negative 9.5. And what we're trying to determine is which of these two possible calculations is correct. Looking at Juan's weight, he did lose 9.5 pounds. That would be represented by a negative. So the question is, well, which of these calculations? So if there's a loss of 9.5 pounds, his change in weight is negative 9.5 pounds. So looking at these two calculations, the top one is not correct. That is actually not going to give you the correct change in weight, because getting 9.5 would have represented gaining 9.5 pounds. Why the second equation is show, or the second calculation is giving us that he lost 9.5 pounds. So that is actually the correct calculation that determines such a change. So just to summarize, for part A, his change in weight is negative 9.5 pounds. That negative matters because this is a loss of weight, and a change can be either positive or negative. And the calculation that produces this is 187.3 minus 196.8 is equal to negative 9.5. So let's now look at part B. His weight then changed from 187.3 pounds to 189.4 pounds. What is the change in Juan's weight? Write the calculation that determines this change. So again, we're going to represent using number line to see what this is happening. We're looking at the starting point and the ending point. The start corresponds to 187.3 pounds ending corresponds to 189.4 pounds. Again, this another way to represent this. We're looking at change. In this case, he gained weight, so we would notice that on the number line, the arrow is going to the right from the starting point. And again, we could represent this using ref as the starting point, and then the final point where it ends would be the current value, which is the end. So again, possible calculations that you might consider is to take 189.4 minus 187.3 is equal to 2.1 to calculate the change. Or you might have considered taking 187.3 minus 189.4 to get negative 2.1. And again, we want to think about which of these two is appropriate and which one that is not. We know that one gained 2.1 pounds. You can see that on the number line. And also intuitively, his weight is more than it was before. So the change in weight is 2.1 pounds. Looking at the two calculations, the only calculation that would make sense is the first calculation. The second one would have indicated he lost 2.1 pounds, or that there was a negative, the change in weight was negative, and that is not correct. He gained 2.1 pounds. He did not lose 2.1 pounds. So his change in weight is 2.1 pounds. Again, the 2.1 is positive to show the gain. The calculation that produces this is 189.4 minus 187.3 is equal to 2.1. Now let's look at some variables as well. So far we've been looking at the quantities, and let's say we wanted to show this using variable notation. Well, the first thing you need to do is to define the variable. So let W represent one's weight in pounds. Now notice that we're interested in the change in one's weight, so we have to think of a notation or a symbol that would help us do that. So let delta W, or the change in W, be this change in his weight. So you notice there's a little triangle in front of the W, and it's referred to delta, and it's because it is the Greek letter D in Greek. So if you were looking at just the first eight letters of the Greek alphabet, you'll notice up here the first letter is alpha, the second letter is beta, third letter is gamma, and the fourth letter is delta. So that that symbol that looks like a triangle really is the capital D in Greek. So that's what we use. As we're looking at this, we're going to try to use this notation to describe the change in one's weight, both for part A and for part B. So delta W is equal to negative 9.5. That would be the symbolic way to represent his change in weight. And then similarly, the symbolic way to represent his change in weight in part B would be delta W, or the change in W is equal to 2.1. So that's how you would do it. We're looking at the formula, or a way to figure out the delta W. We'll notice that in each situation, we were taking the ending weight minus the starting weight, so WN minus W start. And that was true in both cases. That would get us the correct change. But there's a couple of other ways to look at this as well. In other, you might also think of this as the final weight minus the initial weight, where we're using a subscript here to indicate the difference between the two types of W. Because W does measure weight, it's just the status of one's weight, so we have to distinguish that by using subscripts. Another way to think of it is the second weight minus the first weight, where the first weight is how we started and the second weight is how we finished. Or W2 minus W1, which is just a short way of writing second minus first. Another way to look at this is looking at delta W, where the change in W is equal to the current weight minus the reference weight, where the reference weight represents that weight which he started at. Let's look at another example. So when Anne woke up this morning at 5 a.m., the temperature outside was negative 5 degrees Fahrenheit. When she got home from school at 3 p.m., the temperature outside was 18 degrees Fahrenheit. So Anne clearly lives in a place where it's very cold, so we have negative temperatures. So the first question is, what is the change in temperature from 5 a.m. to 3 p.m., and then write a calculation that determines that change. First thing we need to do is define some variables. So let T be the temperature outside in degrees Fahrenheit. And this time what we're going to do is we're going to use a vertical number line to represent the situation. We could have also used a horizontal number line, but just for flexibility, let's see how would this look like on a vertical number line as well. So the points are plotted at the starting temperature, which is at negative 5 degrees, and the ending temperature, which is at 18 degrees. Again, another way to, so what we're looking at is the change in T, is equal to the ending temperature minus the starting temperature. Again, using the same type of formula that we were using when we were looking at the change in one's weight. And based on that, because we saw repeated patterns of how this happened. Or you could think of it as that second temperature minus the first temperature that was measured, or the current temperature minus the reference temperature from where it began. So the reference temperature always refers to where we began to measure or where something started. So let's look at what that's going to look like visually. So that means we can just represent this as reference. And we're going to look at the arrow. So from the reference, the temperature rises up to 18 degrees. So we know intuitively we're expecting to get a gain in temperature. Before we do any calculations, that's what we're expecting. So let's see. Change in T is equal to 18 minus a negative 5. That is the subtraction statement that shows what is the change in temperature. So the change in temperature after you do the math is 23 degrees, which makes sense. Notice it's a gain of 23 degrees from that original reference measure of negative 5 degrees Fahrenheit. So the change in temperature was 23 degrees Fahrenheit. And the calculation that shows that is 18 minus a negative 5 is 23. Now let's look at another one. So the outside temperature next morning at 5 p.m. was negative 9 degrees Fahrenheit. What was the change in temperature from 3 p.m. after school to 5 a.m. that next morning? And the second part of that is to asks us to write the calculation that determines that change. So over here, the starting temperature was the temperature that was measured at 3 p.m. that day, which was 18 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature later is going to be negative 5 degrees Fahrenheit. So again, looking at this, what we're looking at is, again, change in temperature is that final temperature, the end, minus the temperature that it started at, or the second temperature, T2 minus T1, which is meaning the second temperature, minus the first temperature that was measured, or the current temperature, the most current temperature, minus where we began, that reference temperature. The reference temperature in this case is 18 degrees, because that's where the first measurement was taken. So that's, we're basically looking at the change in temperature from 18 degrees Fahrenheit. So when we're looking at this, we're looking at a reference value of 18, and we're noticing from 18, we're going to change a certain number of degrees until it drops down to negative 9. And that's really what the purpose of this is. So when we look at the calculation, we're taking, okay, the current, which was negative 9 minus 18, which is what it started at, or the reference value, and that's negative 27. That's consistent with what we see as a drop of temperature. So the change in temperature is negative 27. And so that's how we would report out that change in temperature was negative 27 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, let's look at part C. By noon, the temperature changed by 25 degrees Fahrenheit from the negative 9 degrees Fahrenheit it was in the morning. What was the temperature at noon? So again, looking at this, our reference temperature from which we are measuring is negative 9 degrees Fahrenheit. And we know there's going to be a positive change of 25 degrees from there. So the question is stated a little bit differently than before. We're actually interested in what the final temperature is rather than trying to find the change. We know what the change is. So in this case, what we're looking at is, okay, so the change in temperature is the ending temperature minus the starting temperature. Another way to look at that is the second temperature minus the first temperature, or that current temperature, which is what we're looking for, minus the reference temperature from which we began. We know two of the values, we don't know the third one. We know there is a gain in temperature, and that change is 25 degrees. So when we look at this, we know 25 is equal to the current temperature, which will be the one that's at noon, minus a negative 9. This is going to take a little bit of algebra. What we're going to do is add negative 9 to both sides to solve for the current temperature. So when we do that, then using a little bit of math, 25 plus negative 9 is 16. So the current temperature is 16. That's what it's going to be at noon, 16 degrees Fahrenheit at noon. Okay, let's look at one more, which is part D. By 8 p.m., the temperature changed by negative 12 degrees Fahrenheit from the temperature that it was at noon. What is the temperature at 8 p.m.? So we know that our temperature at noon was 16 degrees Fahrenheit. That's going to be our reference point, that starting temperature from which we measure the change. We also know that the temperature is going to drop by 12 degrees Fahrenheit from that reference temperature. So we're going back using the same formula that we've been doing before. So the change in T is equal to the ending temperature minus that starting temperature. You can also look at it as the second temperature minus the first, just like T2 minus T1. Or that current temperature minus that reference temperature. Here our reference temperature from which we're measuring is 16 degrees. So we'll put in what we know. First of all, we know it's going to be a drop based on going from the reference value to that final value. And we know the change in temperature is negative 12. So putting in the values, we get negative 12 is equal to the current temperature minus 16. We're going to do a little bit of algebra, add 16 to both sides. And when we do that, negative 12 plus 16 is the current temperature. So that's 4 degrees Fahrenheit. Still pretty cold. It's going to be 4 degrees Fahrenheit at 8 p.m. So let's take a look and see what happened. First of all, we started with the change in temperature is equal to the current temperature minus that reference temperature. With a little bit of algebra, we could add that reference temperature to both sides, and we end up with the change in temperature plus the reference temperature is equal to the current temperature. We're rewriting it so it's a little more easy to read. The current temperature is equal to that change in temperature plus the reference temperature. Okay, let's see how that works in context of this question. Does that match? When we found the current temperature in part C, notice we took 25, which was the change in temperature, plus the reference temperature, which was negative 9. And that correctly determined the current temperature. If you look at part D, that negative 12 did represent the change in temperature, and we added the reference temperature of 16, and that correctly determined the current temperature. So this template of T current is equal to delta T plus T ref is working and consistent with what we are seeing happening. I hope you found it helpful.